A Cessna plane bound for Cagayan with two people on board goes missing. The Civil Aviation Authority of the Philippines says the aircraft took off from Lawag in Ilocos Norte and was expected to land in Tuguegarao. The last recorded location of the plane was estimated around 40 kilometers from Tuguegarao. An initial search conducted by aviation authorities yielded negative results. Now, the bad weather, meanwhile, is hampering search and rescue operations. Let's get an update on the weather now from PAGASA forecaster Ana Clauren. Good morning, Ana. What do you have for us?
Yes, good morning, Ma'am Nikki, and to all our televiewers. The southwest monsoon or the habagat still prevailing here in Luzon and Visayas, bringing monsoon rains over Zambales and Bataan. While here in Metro Manila, Ilocos Region, Pampanga, Bulacan, and Occidental Mindoro for today's weather, we're still expecting occasional rains, while cloudy skies with scattered rain showers and thunderstorms are still expected over the Cordillera Region, Cagayan Valley, Calabar Zone, the rest of Central Luzon, and the rest of Mimaropa. While the whole Visayas and Mindanao are expecting a generally fair weather condition aside from isolated rain showers mostly in the afternoon or in the evening. We still have gale warning rays over the northern seaboards of northern Luzon, particularly in Batanes, the northern coast of Ilocos Norte, and the northern coast of Cagayan, including Babuyan Islands. Fishing boats and other small sea crafts are advised not to venture out into the sea, while the larger sea vessels are alerted against the big waves. And that's the latest from PAGASA. This is Ana Clauren Horda. Good morning.
Thank you, Ana. Parts of Bulacan remain flooded. The province, which has declared a state of calamity, recorded over 90 million pesos worth of damage in agriculture. Bulacan Governor Daniel Fernando says he is planning to build a mega dike to mitigate the flooding problem in the province.
Medyo mahal ito, no? Kasi talagang i-reclaim yung gilid nito, yung ano nito, di ba? Para makagawa ka ng mega dike. According to naman ang pag-aaralan nila, titingnan natin.
Meanwhile, Senator Joel Villanueva of Hales from Bulacan questions where the funds for the flood control project of the Philippine government went.
Hindi tama, palpak ang ating flood control program. Meron po tayong 183 billion na budget, ang DPWH alone, hindi kasama ang DENR, hindi kasama ang ilang ahensya ng pamahalaan. And yet, tingnan nyo, dito sa Bulacan, about 1.7 billion. Pero halos lahat ng towns, lubog. Dito sa Kalumpit, lahat ng barangay, lubog. Dun sa Hagonoy, lahat ng barangay, lubog.
Over in Pampanga, over 600,000 residents are still affected by floods. Some roads remain impassable. A warning was also released as the Pampanga River Basin reaches the critical level. Pampanga is under a state of calamity.
Nakapagbigay na ho tayo ng mga tulong pero kailangan pa rin ho, hindi kakayanin ng probinsya. Kailangan natin tulong ng barangay level, ng municipal level at probinsya. Magtulungan ho tayo.
Over in China, Typhoon Doksuri, which battered the Philippines as Egay, kills at least 20 people. It also caused extensive flooding in Beijing and neighboring Hebei province. Now, electrical lines were downed and many roads were either badly damaged or still flooded. China's finance ministry has announced it would allocate 110 million yuan, or about $15 million, for rescue work. Illogical and stupid, that's how embattled lawmaker Arnulfo Teves Jr. described his designation as a terrorist by the Anti-Terrorism Council. In an online press conference, Teves denied being part of any group that sows terror in Negros Oriental. He again dismissed his designation as a form of political persecution.
Yan yung pinaka-stupido nilang sinabi. Sino namang politiko ang magsusow ng fear? Nangangampanya ka nga para mahalin ka ng tao, sabay pananakot ka. Klaseng katangahan yun, di ba? Sa totoo lang. Di ba? You're wooing people to love you, to vote for you. Paano ka mananalo ng eleksyon kung tatakotin mo yung tao?
After being designated a terrorist, the Philippine government has frozen the assets of Teves. His lawyers now plan to have Teves delisted, saying the resolution was based on initial statements from suspects who have since recanted their claims against the lawmaker. But the Justice Department insists they have a strong case against Devers.
The 10 recanting at the same time only furthers the theory that there really exists a conspiracy behind the recantation.
Congressman Tevez, meanwhile, believes his terrorist designation will be used to expel him from the House of Representatives. RG Cruz reports.
After a meeting that started from past 1 p.m. until almost sundown, the House Committee on Ethics and Privileges announced it has acquired jurisdiction over Negros Oriental 3rd District Representative Arnolfo Tevez Jr. following the lapse of his second 60-day suspension from the chamber. Tevez was suspended for failure to physically come to work, as ordered by the House leadership. But now he has another problem before the panel, his designation as a terrorist by the Anti-Terrorism Council, a copy of which has reached the panel. Representatives of the Department of Justice, Department of Foreign Affairs, Bureau of Immigration, National Bureau of Investigation, and the Anti-Terrorism Council were in the meeting with the panel.
Pinag-aaralan pa namin kung mayroong bearing, no? Yung resolution ng ATC na dinedesignation terorista. Sapagkat sabi naman ng ATC na there's only one reason why, no, na siya ay tinagda-terorista, so that they could be able to freeze the assets. Yun lang eh, yung AMLA.
The investigation will continue to aid the panel in making its recommendation, but the panel insists it wants to hear from their colleague, not his lawyer. Tevez also has to ask the speaker for permission to join via teleconferencing.
If ever Congressman Arnie Tevez would want to be involved in the investigation at hindi siya makapunta dito, well, he has to make his personal request, not through his lawyers.
Tevez, however, asserts that he can be represented by his counsel.
Kung ako yung nililitis, dapat akong pakinggan. I have the right to be heard personally or through a counsel.
The committee has not discussed sanctions yet, but a member admits that the House has been affected by what's been happening to Tevez Jr.
First time nangyari yan sa amin. Eh. Siya nag-cause kung bakit ang buong kongresong ito is under scrutiny.
Tevez Jr. believes the designation will be used to expel him from the House.
Of course, gagamitin nila lahat ng kaya nilang gawin. Dahil other than meron silang minamanok, may interest sila sa distrito, ang daming may mga vested interest eh. Other than gusto nila akong patahimikin.
The committee denies it is in cahoots with anyone against the lawmaker, adding that the issuance of the terrorist designation on the same day the panel was meeting was but a coincidence.
We are doing everything we can to let our people realize na ito, hindi ito railroading.
The panel may release its decision in the next few weeks. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.
The prosecution in the remaining drug case of former Senator Laila de Lima seeks the return of the New Bilibid prison of three witnesses who have yet to testify in her case. This after they were transferred to the Sablayan prison in Occidental Mindoro over the weekend. A subpoena was also issued, ordering the three convicted witnesses to attend their hearings in September. But both camps clarify they saw nothing wrong with the transfer.
They are convicted, no? So, medyo under the custody of the Bucor na.
So, it's up to Bucor today.
It's up to Bucor. Ang problema kasi talaga namin is prior to the hearing, we really need to confer with them before they testify.
Wala kami nakikitang mali or tama dyan. Ang gusto lang namin, during their presentation, ay ma-present. We want to observe the demeanor of these witnesses. Tulad ng mga nakaraan, kasi gusto namin face-to-face talaga, yung right to confront the witnesses, ma-avail talaga ng mga akusado.
Dilima's motion for reconsideration over the denial of her bail plea meanwhile remains pending before a Mutinlupa court. The Philippine government's debt reaches a new record in June. Data from the Treasury Bureau show the total outstanding debt hit 14.15 trillion pesos, up nearly 0.5% from the previous month. And it's also 10.6% higher from the same period a year ago. This on the back of more domestic borrowings, which rose 1.2%. The Bureau says domestic debt grew in June due to the net assistance of government bonds driven by the government's financing requirements. The Land Transportation Franchising and Regulatory Board likely to approve a proposed rush hour rate for jeepneys and buses. Some Philippine transport groups have appealed to the board to come up with a measure that would help the sector deal with high oil prices. Now, under the scheme, 1 peso will be added to the base fare of jeepneys, while the base fare of city buses will increase by 2 pesos during the peak commuting hours.
Mawawala sa driver ngayon mga 150 pesos a day. Na iyan ay pwede sa computation ko, may pang-almusal na ng kape tinapay, may pambigas na at saka itlog na mabibili. Yun ang nawala sa kita ng driver ngayon sa 350. And hindi natin ma-expect, baka next week tumaas na naman to.
The LTFRB says they expect a decision on their appeal 2 weeks from now. The regulatory board also eyeing an alternative solution by distributing financial aid to affected operators.
In the event na kulang yung fuel subsidy, we may resort to granting the request but not probably as high as 1 peso. Depende po. Now, if the fuel subsidy is not available yet, then we may grant the request for a 1 peso increase. But this will be subject to a study which we are doing right now.